Hey everyone, this is eplipswich here, and today I'm bringing to you guys a visual novel called Japanese School Life. Yes. Well, I didn't say this before, so I'll say it now. I've been longing to want to try out a visual novel, and so there you go. A visual novel called Japanese School Life with Joshi Kosei. So why do I want to try this game out? It's because this game reminds me of Tokyo School Life, and for those that played Tokyo School Life, it's basically about a foreigner who went to Japan to, you know, for a 3-month exchange program at a Japanese high school in Tokyo. So there he met 3 girls, and then towards the end of the game, you know, you get to choose 1 or 3 girls to go out with. So I guess this game, Japanese School Life, is kind of similar, except instead of 3 months, the protagonist of this game by the name of Brian will be studying in a Japanese high school for 1 year, and as the screen suggests, he will meet these 2 girls and probably will choose which one of these girls you want to fall in love with. So yeah. Okay, actually, I'm currently playing the demo version because I haven't decided whether I want to buy this game yet. So I'm trying this demo out, and then I'll see if it's fun. If it's fun, then I'll buy it. So yeah, let's take a look at this game now. By the way, this game was created by Sekai Project and has recently been released. So yeah, let's start the game. New game. Alright, the blue sky, cloudy sky as usual. You know, like, because in common Japan, you always see the clouds, right, at the start of anything, anime games and that. Anyway, it is a calm day with warm sunshine. Spring in Japan is gentle and carries with it the pleasant air of finely polished glass. As cherry blossoms sway and swirl in an intricate dance around me, I take my first step into a new world. Finally, starting today, I'm a Japanese high school student. I studied so hard for this, but it all paid off. I got a chance to come here as an exchange student. The flight is approximately 14 hours. I spent almost an entire day in transit just to reach these far and foreign shores, but I am here now, in Japan. It was a week ago when I arrived in this country, almost bursting with excitement. Dressed in an unfamiliar uniform, I felt every bit a Japanese high school student. I almost made sure to snap a nice commemorative photo of myself and send it off to my mom and dad. And now, it is my first day at school. I'm gonna make so many friends at this school. Then I'm gonna indulge fully in my main interest, otaku culture. I hope you're familiar with otaku culture, unlike the protagonist in Tokyo School Life. But yeah. This country is home to all my hopes and dreams. I've got to study hard so I can understand my beloved Japanese culture more deeply. Okay, it's my turn next. I spend my first few moments in class doing a self-introduction. I need to tell everyone in my class my name. I'm sort of nervous, but I have to do this right. Let me work out what to say in my head. Nice to meet you all. My name is Brian. Alright, that should be good. All I have to do now is to say it. As long as I talk clearly, they should understand. Well, I hope you can speak Japanese well. It seems like it's my turn. All around me are Japanese people of my age. I'm probably a rare sight, gaijin as they call it. Foreigner. They are staring at me. In any case, I have to relax. Nice and easy now. Let's talk. I'm from America. I came to Japan to study. Please call me Brian. It's my first time here in Japan, and I'm really excited. Nice to meet you all. Right. Seems like I made sense. Everyone is clapping. They're okay with what I said. I sit down and take a short breather, allowing the tension to flow out of my body. Next, I have to make sure I listen carefully to everyone else's introductions and remember them all. I want to meet those 2 girls right now though. Come on. Come on. That wraps up the introductions. I think we're free to do whatever we want for now. All the students have left their seats and are talking with their friends. Japanese high schools assign seats to each student. The teacher for each subject comes to our classroom to teach his or her lesson. I feel someone's eyes on me. I must really stick out like a sore thumb here. I do want to go talk to people, but I have no idea how to start things off. Oh, and there we go, the first girl. Huh? You mean me? Ah, I see. There we go, the first girl. Alright, got it. Honda Chiyoko. The girl who sits in the seat next to me comes to talk to me. I'm nervous, but I have to respond properly. Nice to meet you. I'm Brian. Yeah. Right, I hope so too. Yes, that's right. Yes, I've always been fascinated by Japanese culture. Who would have thought my neighbor would be such a cute, friendly girl? I'm really lucky! Ah, I see. What a coincidence. That's really helpful of you. Thanks! Class presidents. I believe they act as the representative of their class. In Japanese high schools, each class has one student who represents them as the class president. I'm not really familiar with the system. I guess it's because classes have fixed rooms, so they each need a student who represents them. This girl then will be the one who represents us. Is it okay for me to call you Chiyoko? I think that's the given name, right? Yeah, that's the given name, Chiyoko. Whoa! All of a sudden you call a Japanese girl by the given name? Okay. Oh, of course. I'm cool. Okay, I hope we get along, Chiyoko. Okay, so Chiyoko is okay with, you know, Brian calling her by her given name. Or the first name, right? Our class president is in the seat beside me. It seems like I'll have plenty of chances to talk to her. I hope we become good friends. Oh, thanks. I'm really happy. It was my dream to come to Japan. Of course. I mean, it's a Japanese high school, you know. Yes, the uniforms look so cool and cute. Don't you think so? Yeah, she's really cute when she smiles. I hurriedly cast my eyes downward before I lose myself staring at her. Oh, it's nothing. I'm just, you know, staring. I don't know what am I saying. Nothing. Don't worry about it. I'm not used to being around girls, so it's embarrassing when our eyes meet. I always blush and stare at them. It's been a habit of mine since a long time ago. There's absolutely no way I'll ever be able to say something like, "Chiyoko, you're really cute." Why not, though? Well, I guess. Huh? I wanted to talk to someone, but I wasn't sure how I was supposed to go about it. Ah, I see. Okay, of course I won't. I'm as nervous as they are, which is why I was looking around so much. She listens to me with a smile on her face. It seems like I'll have a really nice girl sitting next to me. Yeah, I don't... Right, I was given a tour of the school, but the town is still a mystery to me. Oh, of course, sure. Really? Would you? Okay, you're right to be honest, I did plenty of studying, but still... Thank you so much. I'm really glad you're doing this for me. Okay. What an angel of a girl. I really am lucky. Oops, that's the other girl who calls Chiyoko by the name Choco. Okay. Hmm? Ah, I guess this looks a bit like the tsundere type, but we'll see. Huh? A girl suddenly comes and talks to me. Unlike Chiyoko, she's very lively and animated. Oh, right. Oh, okay, nice to meet you too. I'm Brian. Okay, I guess she's a very enthusiastic person. Not the type of person I'm particularly comfortable around. Ah, I see, so this protagonist is the shy type. Chiyoko and Arisa, are the two of you fans? Right now, we are second year students in high school. That means Chiyoko and Arisa became fans a year ago. Not really. I mean, they could be friends from before high school, you know. Ah, I see. I guess Chiyoko really is as caring a person as I thought she would be. She came and talked to me, and she also offered to show me around town. Oh, did I actually say they're cute? Eh, but actually come to think of it, do uniforms really have such large ribbons like this? I'm not that familiar with the Japanese schools, but I don't know. I think these uniforms look pretty cute, no? With those big red ribbons. Especially with Arisa's one with the big red ribbon and a yellow star there or something. And even Arisa's pony, the hairband also has some stars and all that. Whereas, well, Chiyoko's has a big with red ribbon with red hairband with a big there, something like that. Yeah. So yeah, it's actually pretty cool, you know. Pretty cute. I mean, right, anyway, yeah, this is the first time I've had a dress code for attending class. Huh? Ask me? Okay, sure. Could you also tell me all sorts of things about Japan? Like, what food you eat? What drinks you drink, what places you go to and all that? Anything. I'm curious about everything. Yeah, I do. See, very straightforward. Ask for numbers, yeah. I like this kind of girl. Of course. No way! I've become fans with girls on my first date! Arisa's charming smile causes my heart to stutter a little. I thought I would be uncomfortable around her at first, but that turned out to be entirely untrue. Arisa's a really nice girl, and I also thought that she would be a tsundere, but apparently not. Okay. Sure, thanks both of you. Wow, actually they are like really very friendly. I mean, it's like straight away they They are no nonsense. They are the no nonsense type. Straight, okay, I want to be friends with you. But I guess that's expected because, I mean, you are the foreigner here, so, you know, so naturally, the students will be excited about a foreigner coming to, you know, joining in class and all that. Yeah. Particularly in Japan. Yeah. Huh? We're going to play? Yeah, play. What? Why can't I play? Can't I play and know about the... Oh, yeah, why can't I play and know the town at the same time? Okay, alright. Thanks to the generosity of those two, I'm gonna go on a tour through the town. This is my chance to both learn about Japan and get to know the two of them better. Okay. So. Oh, I like the animation. Ooh, this is pretty cool, the animation. So, yeah, like, yeah. And their breeding state stances and all that. Yeah, pretty cool. But A, we don't get to check out the town, the players don't get to see the town. I wonder where this place is anyway. Tokyo, I guess? No, I think I'm fine. Thanks a lot for telling me so much about this place. Oh, now this really looks a bit more like an animation. Because earlier that CG didn't have any animations, so we get to see some animations, yeah. Really interesting. Wait, pizza man? By the way, if you guys don't know what man is, I think man refers to those steam buns. So, pizza man is... well, steam bun with pizza stuffing, I guess? Yep, nikuman is basically meat bun. Yeah, meat steam bun. I have no idea. What is that? Is it good? Okay, and there she goes. Well, I guess. Oh, yeah, I'm pretty hungry actually. No, not exactly. How come Japanese girls eat so dry? How can you ask such a question? But okay. Yeah! I mean, that's not a question you should ask. How should you expect an answer, you know? Huh? I suppose I'll chalk that up to cultural differences. Yeah, it's actually cultural differences, yeah. Being brought up in different environments probably has something to do with it. You know, like Americans, they tend to eat a lot. Yeah. Whereas Japanese, on the other hand, they are more reserved, so the food, they don't eat a lot. I see. Maybe that explains why Japanese girls are so small and skinny. Oh no, Brian. You shouldn't be saying such a thing. Oh, no. That's not what you should be saying to a girl. Come on, Brian. No, you shouldn't be saying that. You're insulting her, you know, by saying such a thing. No. What's the matter? Did I say something weird? Yeah, you certainly did. Oh, okay, thanks. The thanks. Wow, it's hot. Okay, Okay, sure. Okay, I'll try some. Taking care not to burn myself, I take a bite. Mmm, this is good! Wow, it's oishi! Delicious! The outside is mildly sweet, and the inside is filled with meat. One bite, and I'm in love with it! Oops. Yeah, I'm glad you like it, huh? Yeah, this is great! I love it! Yep, it's yeah, Chinese meat buns or nikuman. Yeah. Let me pay you for that, Arisa. I'd rather not have you foot the bill. Hmm, okay. Yeah, and as you know, 100 yen means like US $1. So yeah, it's actually pretty cheap, you know, for nikuman, like $1 like that. Huh? You can eat one of these for 100 yen? Oh, okay. I recall Japan having a uniform tax rate across the country. Okay. Huh. Japanese convenience stores actually do live up to their image. You can't walk for 5 minutes without finding one, and most of them are open 24 hours. They're stocked with food, drinks, and sweets. They even have magazines and daily necessities. Everything you need to go about your daily life can be found there. Okay. Huh? You mean the same products have different prices? Yeah, they certainly do. Talk about instant noodles, okay. Yeah, really? Yeah, so you know, if you the next time you go on a vacation to Japan, like if you don't to spend too much money, you can like wait until the late night where then go camp at the outside the convenience stores and then yeah and then go buy those food because they need to sell off all the food, right? So that's where you can get those food at the cheapest prices, at discounted prices. So yeah, but that's if you're pretty desperate lah. Yeah. Okay. I see. From now on, I'm gonna take the time to go to supermarkets then. I have to save money by stocking up on instant noodles and buying half-price groceries. No, don't stock up on instant noodles. Instant noodles are bad for your health. Please. Ah, okay. Really? What can those convenience stores do then? Yeah, actually there are plenty of things they can't do, like I don't know. Like, play games? You know? Yeah, anyway. Oh, really? You mean this? Oh yeah, those kind of cards. Okay. 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 Wow, this is a magic card. So convenient. You can use it at all sorts of places around town. Japan really is living in the future. Okay. Wow, they're pretty incredible. Okay. Really? That makes this one feel a little special somehow. Like I have to pay you back. Yeah, thanks, Arisa. Okay. Ah, really? Okay. Cute? Oh, what should I do? That's the first time a girl has said something like that to me. They don't worry, don't panic, Ryan. I mean, that's a good thing, you know, when someone calls you cute, that's a good thing. Don't panic, just accept it. Oh, yeah, I'm cute, yeah. But I think, you know, they seem really, really friendly, like the point where they're maybe a bit too friendly, I guess. But I don't know, do they have any motives? I probably not, but we'll see. Ah. Actually, I can't remember what anman is. I know man is the steam bun, but an, I can't quite remember what is anman though. Can I click on the words? Oh, I totally can. I just noticed. Okay, so anman, pizza man. Okay. Pizza man is basically steam bun stuffed with pizza. Yeah, like I said, anman is the red bean, the sweet bean paste. Huh? Yeah, that's called an. So it's anman. All right, got it. Okay, then Nikuman is meat steam bun. Yes, okay, got it. Thank you for the explanation. What? Am I allowed to eat something Arisa has already taken a bite out of? I know it's what you call indirect kiss, but I mean, go ahead, man. This is your chance. No. I do. I'll try some then. Nervously, I take a bite out of the pastry that Arisa's holding. Wow, this is really sweet. Yeah, it's sweeter than I thought. Oh, so that's not so sweet bean bun? Sure. This time, I take a bite out of Chiyoko's pastry. I like this one better. It tastes like pizza. Also, the one Chiyoko's eating is pizza man. Maybe? No, I beg to differ. Okay, this is a bit awkward though. Okay. Yeah, very awkward. Watching girls eat snacks with a look of pure happiness on their faces is an enjoyable experience, definitely. Okay. So. I see some word called cargo or bargo over to the left hand side. I guess we're going shopping. What do the two of you usually do after school?
子と遊んだり、他の子に誘われて遊びに行ったりしてるかな。
Okay. Really? You're always playing?
そうだよ。チョコが毎日遊んでくれてもいいんだけどね。私にもいろいろ用事があるの。遊んでばっかりもいられないでしょ。女子高生の時間を大切にしなよ。勉強なんて後でもできるじゃん。
Okay. Yeah, yeah, that's true. You have to play hard, no? Yeah, work hard. Yeah, I know there's work hard and play hard, but sometimes there's also a rule that you can play hard first, then work hard later. Something like that. But anyway. Okay. Okay. Do you mind if I ask what exactly is it? It is you, you know, play? Yeah, that's the kind of thing you can't really research on the internet. Yeah, definitely. I mean, this is personal thing, so yeah. Oh, she's pulling her. Whoa! And me. Okay. Oh! So, the play that you're talking about is karaoke? Okay. Oh, I can't sing though. Actually, I think I'll pass. I'm not very familiar with this. Well, okay. Really? I don't think I need to explain what karaoke means, right? Even though you can click on the word here. But I think everyone knows what karaoke is, so yeah. Oh, okay. Really? Okay. No, Brian will hear it. I take a look at my surroundings. It's a small room with a large monitor, under which are various small devices. Ah, so this is what karaoke looks like. Wait, you don't know what karaoke is, Brian? You don't have a karaoke at home or something? Yeah, I knew what they're like on paper, but it was hard to find an actual brick and mortar location. Well, instead of going to a specific place, people who like to sing just, you know, sing wherever they feel like it. Ah, I see what you mean. Oops, I'm sorry. Sorry to cut you off there. Haha, yeah, I hear a lot of Japanese people are shy. Not saying that I don't have the guts to attempt something like that, of course. Okay, I see. So that's why. That explains how this culture of singing in private rooms came to be. But well, it's not just in Japan, no. Like, there are other countries that are also like that. I think mostly Asia. Singapore, I know, is one of them. Yes, and... Don't worry, Shoko, just sing. I'll be rooting for you. Sing in front of two girls is a little... What? Brian, don't be a coward. Come on, be a man. Sing! See? That's the spirit, man. Aris, you go, Arisa. Come on, Brian, sing. For some reason, the one who's channeling my own country's vibe, the strongest is Arisa. Oh, we don't get to hear them sing. So boring, man. We don't get to hear them sing. And Brian sing too. Yeah. Actually, there's one other thing that I've been wondering for a while now. I feel like the way Arisa says your name is a little different from how I do it. Yeah, it's a nickname, you know, like Choco, chocolate. Yeah. I mean, don't you even know this, Brian? Haven't you heard of nicknames? A nickname? You don't know what a nickname is? What? See? Chocolate, no? I see. Well, yeah, it's kind of cute, but you know, you're calling someone chocolate, it's like, I don't know. Can I call you that too, Brian? You want to call her chocolate too? Are you serious? Are you serious, Brian? Okay. Okay, now you made her embarrassed. It's easier for me to say too. Can I? Wow, really? Just because it's easier to say. Are you serious? How different is it? Chiyoko and Choco. I mean, it's just one syllable difference. But anyway, deep down, you see, I knew you have a motive, Brian. There's actually another reason. I want to become closer to Chiyoko. And Choco is really cute. I knew you have an excuse for this, Brian. Really? Great! Thanks! Alright. Okay. Smiling, Choco says that with a mild blush. It's sort of embarrassing for me, too, but I should try to summon the courage to say out loud. Yeah. I hope we do, Choco. Okay, and there we have it, the end of day one, I guess. I guess we maybe go back to the bedroom or something like that. Oh. This is the intro video. Alright, so that one earlier was the prologue. Alright. So let's watch the opening for a bit. Alright, so now we're on day 2 of this game. Phew! The next class is... Oh man, it's maths. I'm terrible at math, so that's sort of a bummer. Of course, I can understand what the numbers mean, but calculating things is hard. In a way, it's even harder than understanding words. Japanese high schools have a system where the teachers for each subject come to our classroom. Yes, we get that. Therefore, we rarely have any reason to leave our classroom. The only time we go to a different classroom is for special classes such as music or art, for which specific tools or instruments are necessary. Also, each morning begins with our homeroom teacher who is in charge of our class. There's a simple morning routine that we do. It's like a greeting. I was at a loss in the beginning, but recently I'm starting to understand how it works. Yeah, I'm adjusting well. It's taking some time, but I'm getting there. Also, recently, I'm getting to the point where I can talk to other people. I've had lots of conversations with the other guys in our class already. Like yesterday, I promised Kawasaki-kun, Yoshimura-kun, and Motokuchi-kun we'll head out somewhere. And thanks to you, Anarisa, I'm starting to understand the school rules as well. Japanese high schools have a lot of rules that are first for me. However, with the help of Choco and Arisa, I managed to get by without too much trouble. Oh, don't remind me of that. No. I hate cleanup. Cleanup, yeah. That's one of those things about Japanese schools that was an eye-opener for me. After school every day, the students themselves clean the school. Let's see what they have here. Ah, okay, right. Yeah, I know. I mean, this is a daily routine. Like, every day we have cleanup duty, so take turns cleaning the classrooms and all that. Yeah. Yeah, I don't like cleaning. I hate it, yeah. Organizing and cleaning things might be my least favorite activity. Well, yeah, I guess that's true. Okay, seeing Choco's smile motivates me. Was I always this simple? Oh. Okay. Japanese schools don't seem to have cafeterias. They don't? I'm pretty sure they do. Like, there's another term for it called canteen. Yeah. But yeah, traditionally they tend to eat bentos and all that. But there is, I'm pretty sure, Japanese schools do have cafeterias. They do. Yeah, anyway. Instead, everyone either brings bentos from home or goes to the convenience store to buy things like pastries for lunch. I'm feeling pretty hungry too. Oh, so you hate maths too? Oh, okay. I personally like maths though, so... Okay, that's beside the point, but anyway. Me too. I'm terrible at math. I hope it ends quickly. You too? That stuff's just too hard to solve, right? I see that Arisa and I have lots in common. Not me though. I actually love maths. Yes, I'm a math person, so you know, yeah. We just sympathized with each other over how much we hate math, too. Lately, we've totally been like BFFs. Okay. Oh, it's so fast holidays already. Okay. Holidays, huh? Okay, it's lunchtime. Apparently, Arisa's mom prepares her bento for her every morning. By working some magic with the leftovers from the previous evening's dinner, she makes it during the frenzy that is morning every day. Oh, meatball, nice. Choco, on the other hand, makes her own bentos. It's amazing that you make your own bentos. Okay. Okay. I can't cook, so I buy bentos from the convenience store. Even those are more than tasty enough, which again speaks to how amazing Japan is. There's a school store too, and you can apparently buy pastries there. The place is full of students at lunchtime, so it's hard for people like me who aren't used to school yet to buy anything there. Well, first things first, where exactly am I in Japan? Till now, I still don't know where I am exactly. Tokyo or what? As we eat lunch, the topic turns to how they'll take me somewhere during the holidays. I respond almost immediately to Choco's inquiry. Akihabara! I want to go to Akihabara! Okay, that means confirm. This place is in Tokyo because Akihabara is part of Tokyo. And I guess if this is not Tokyo, it wouldn't make sense, no? Like, travel long distance just to go to Akihabara. So yeah. I think this is most definitely Tokyo. Yeah. I'm sure you all know why Akihabara is the perfect place to go for otakus, right? Yeah, so. Oh, why do you look so sad, Chiyoko? Do you not like otaku culture? Okay. Or are you secretly an otaku? Ah, you're secretly an otaku, but not to worry because Brian is an otaku too. Okay. Golden Week. Yes, the day one of my dreams come true is finally approaching. I can feel my excitement building. I was so chilled last night that I didn't sleep a wink. I still feel like a million bucks. A million bucks, really? Why you ask? Well, that's because I'm finally going to Akihabara, the land of my dreams. And I can, if you notice, the camera is kind of like panning slowly to the left. Okay. I guess they're walking. I've wanted to go there for so long, and at long last, I'm getting the chance. Akihabara, the holy ground of anime, manga, and game culture. I see this. Oh, holy ground is otaku jargon. Alright. For a foreign otaku like me, it's a place that's guaranteed to be on my bucket list. I really have to thank Choco and Arisa, dear the angels who granted my wish. It's a weekend today, but according to the calendar, it's a holiday, so people have the day off. I also see far fewer uniformed students than usual. Starting today, I've got almost an entire week off. Japan's holidays sure are weird. Yeah, the Golden Week. You know, it's pretty cool that they have a week off, you know. Choco explained to me that the holidays stretching from the end of April to the beginning of May are known as Golden Week. I can't help but feel that these holidays seem odd. Why don't they just make it one continuous stretch of holidays? If you're going to rest, then get a good rest. That's clearly more efficient. Having a few weekdays in between that aren't holidays just seems strange. I guess this is one of those rare irrationalities about Japan. Yeah, Japan is weird, you know. Then again, it sort of fits the image of the hardworking Japanese. Oh, Despite it supposedly being a holiday, I see plenty of people in suits. I suppose this scene I'm seeing right now is a pretty good snapshot of modern Japan, I guess. I love Japan, but I doubt I could ever end up like that. I recall Arisa saying, I want to have all of Golden Week off. I couldn't agree more. Man, Arisa and I have so much in common. Oh, it's Choco. I spot Choco within the sea of people in the distance. Nope, I didn't. No, don't worry about it. I'm the one enjoying the tour after all. Oh, so Ryan was alone, okay. No, I haven't heard anything from her. I checked my smartphone, but there are no new messages. She said she had something to do at school. I wonder what it is. I thought the two of you would have come together. Oh, Bukatsu. Let me try to remember what Bukatsu means. I think it means tuition. Oh, yeah, oh right. Bukatsu is club activity, not tuition, but club activity. Bukatsu though. Oh, I wonder what club activity she does. Bukatsu? Oh, like sports. Each Japanese school has its own variety of clubs and activities. They call those extra curriculars Bukatsu. What kind of sports does Arisa play? Well, actually, Bukatsu is not just limited to sports. It can be any club, you know, like chess club, music club, yeah, you know, that sort of thing. Yeah. Ah. Well, as long as she's exercising, that's and having fun, that's what's most important. Really? Why did she join the team then? Yeah, see? Back in my country, people who join clubs and teams are all serious about what they do. Yeah, that certainly are. Oh, okay. Yeah, I got one too. My smartphone displays a message from Arisa that says, "Sorry, almost there." Sure. By the way, is everyone in Japan using this? You mean the smartphone? Oh, the messaging app or the LINE app, alright. I point to the messaging app on my smartphone that the two of them told me about. The app has a green icon and it also has a function where if you send a message, it tells you when the other person read it. Yeah, it's the LINE app. Although, you know, it's like internationally, this app is known as the common app used internationally is WhatsApp, right? But in Japan, they use LINE more often than WhatsApp. So, yeah. It'd be hard if people were all using different apps. What was it like before then? You know, just mailing, you know? Wait, Pokeberu? Oh, this is new to me. Sounds a bit like Pokemon, but I don't think that's the case. But wait. Pokeberu. Beru, I guess something like berry? So, I don't know. Blackberry? Anyway, Pokeberu? Ah, I think I know what this is. This is a pager. Yes, the kind where you send messages. Then if you want to call back, you have to look for a public phone. Yeah, it's a pager. Yeah, those were the days. Yeah. So a pager is called Pokeberu. Got it. Yeah, oh, you mean pagers. Wow, serious? Different codes for different terms? That's pretty cool. Huh? Why? Because it's, you know, too long, I guess? Oh, I see. Okay, okay, okay. Makes sense. Ha! Right. Ah, that makes sense. That makes a lot of sense. Ohio, right? Ohio. Yeah, Ohio. My brain hurts. Yeah, but I totally get the picture, yes. It seems like I have to learn more Japanese to make sense of what she just said. But it's pretty interesting. I guess I don't think America has that sort of thing. Like, I know there's such a thing as Morse code, but we don't use that commonly or something like that. Yeah. This just makes me more interested in Japanese. Oh, I got another one from Arisa. She says, one more minute. Oh, a single picture delivers a response of or expresses an emotion. So basically, it's called an emoticon. The Japanese have an especially good sense of how to use those. But is this a cat? Okay, I really can't tell whether it's cute or not. Maybe Choco has a weird idea of what's cute. Hey, it's Arisa. Okay, don't worry about it, Arisa. Okay, having too much fun? You're always so energetic after all. Okay. Okay, so we're going to Akihabara. That's cool. Oh, wow! How many times have I seen this place on the internet and wished I were here? Now I'm actually here. I'm in Akiba. Well, I guess this is actually a good place to stop. So, yes, my impressions of this visual novel, I think it's actually kind of generic if you ask me, to be honest. Like, there's nothing really interesting so far. I mean, it's just okay, you have a boy come to Japan on an exchange program, and then meet these two girls who suddenly acts so friendly towards them, very outgoing, and then the next thing you know, they are friends already, and then now they are hanging out and all that. Compare this to Tokyo High School though. I think Tokyo High School is better, because Tokyo High School, at least in the beginning, there's a lot of surprises. Yeah, you know, like how the boy and the girls met and all that, those unfortunate incidents and all that. But none of that sort in this game, so yeah, it feels kind of generic, nothing really exciting happening. So yeah, but other than that, I guess it's a decent game, but not something that wows me or what. But yeah, either way though, some of you may enjoy this game, so I hope all of you viewers enjoyed watching this playthrough. If you like what you see of this game, do check out the link to this game in the description below. And so, thank you so much for watching this playthrough, and I hope to see all of you again next time.